I think that the movie does a good job really telling a story for everybody. Even if you don't know sports, even if you're not a sport person, at the end of the day, it's about family and the family that you have and the family that you pick. And for you actors, you get to pick a lot of families when you're making movies. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, we also get disowned by a lot of families and not chosen on the other side. You know, these guys, these football players, it's an interesting life they live. It's a performance-based business. If you're not performing, you're gone. And a lot of and there's some parallels in the industry that we're with.
Mm-hmm. And I think that you can also empathize with the whole thing about expectations. Because sometimes you go to an audition and you're waiting for the call, and also sometimes rejection. How do you deal with that?
I don't think you can let yourself be defined by every little success or failure that you have. Or you just can't. I think that's where the sense of having a little bit of an ego comes in to actually help you live your life. Because if you got crushed by every, you know, time we were rejected for a film, or like likewise with the characters in the movie, just because you don't get picked number one in the draft, I think you're gonna be okay. You're gonna be okay.
If you could pick your dream team for a movie, what would be number one, number two? Talking about actors or directors, or if you could just pick whoever you want.
Well, I can tell you that, I mean, it's kind of crazy. I just worked with somebody who's like that. I mean, Kevin would have been, you know, would be a high draft choice for me in that scenario for sure.
Yeah, and I mean, you can drink things to enhance your performance as an athlete. What can you drink to be more like Kevin Costner? Because he keeps getting better and better.
Yeah.
Dos Equis. I don't know.
He's an interesting guy. It was really cool to be around him and see how he operates and what he cares about and his level of passion and commitment and professionalism. And it's inspiring.
How about training physically? Do you have to do something special for this? Or now when you are this age in Hollywood, you need to always keep up?
I didn't have time. I know that Josh did a lot.
Yeah, I had like 3 weeks to, you know, and Ivan's idea of this character was sort of Tim Tebow-ish. So, you know, and Tim Tebow's 6'3", 250, 245, something like that. And I'm 60 pounds less than that. So it was taking that on, doing all the training, eating 8,000 calories a day for 3 weeks and gaining 20 pounds and working with a football coach and all that stuff, which then on the day, none of that is really, no one is going to see that necessarily, but hopefully in the way that it comes through.
Hollywood keeps making superhero movies, and I'm pretty sure that at your age, the way you guys look, you sometimes are in the conversation for that kind of things. Are you excited about that, or you want to keep making more these kind of movies?
I mean, I'm open to a lot of different opportunities going forward. I mean, I love that genre of film. I think they're fun, they're exciting, it's a good escape, and you always feel better after you watch them, I find.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much, man.
Thanks, Nestor.
Have a good one. Have a good day.